Greetings, this is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Today's talk focuses on new developments with trucks and the value proposition in a new way. Bonjour, wie geht's? Wie steht's noch immer aus Freibeinen? Strasvice, ni hao ma. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Each week I try to do at least one post related to trucks or developments that might be occurring. Clearly it's a better idea to sort of cover new ground versus old ground. And I've had a sort of a discussion based on some research I've wanted to do for a while, and it was focused on a product by Mercedes called the eCanter. Mercedes has a division called Fuso, where they own 87% of it, and the remainder is owned by a company called Mitsubishi. So that distribution is primarily in Japan, but it's really all over the world. They currently have 4 million light-duty trucks around the world under that brand that exist. The focus of my talk today is sort of new developments on the value proposition of the electric battery. In particular, what I was amazed by is that Mercedes tested the eCanter in different types in Portugal for about a year, and the customers of the product found that they saw a 60% reduction in overall costs when it came to using the eCanter. Now, my understanding of sort of how and where these trucks were used is that one of the things that a Portugal environment didn't have to deal with was the weather and elevation differences that you might find, let's say, in Stuttgart, Germany, where Mercedes-Benz is headquartered. And so there's a, you know, would this work in other places issue that popped up. And the answer to that came in that similar trucks were tried over the last, let's say, year in Japan, and 7-Eleven in Japan was experiencing about a 40% reduction in overall cost. So as they went electric, not only were they seeing lower costs when it came to fuel, but in terms of repair costs for the vehicles, etc. These two sort of developments, if you will, has resulted in customers that have had experiences with the light-duty electric trucks, where we have Tesla batteries paired with sort of Mercedes solution trucks. The customers like them enough that they're saying that we'll take as many or buy as many or lease as many as can be produced. So I actually think this is the source of Elon Musk's comments regarding unlimited demand from customers. The only place I could find where the real semis he's talking about are being tested, experimented with, etc., is in Germany, again with Mercedes, and they are currently running tests with engineering teams following the trucks to sort of manage issues that might pop up well. We're going to find out from Elon if, you know, there are other locations that were being tested on the semi that are a reflection of the unlimited demand he talked about. But we'll see how that part works. The other thing that's going on that I was really sort of shocked and amazed by was that now that we've moved from the 81650 to the 2170 battery, most of the sort of development on trucks, particularly with the Mercedes relationship, has focused on the older battery. And one of the lurking questions is, as supply comes on from the Gigafactory, do they put the new batteries in the trucks? Do they stay with the old battery? I believe that in order to focus on the semi, the new battery actually carries more power but weighs less. And I think it's an important transition in terms of how the products are going to work. So it'll be interesting to see this sort of battery toting truck and battery at 80,000 pounds to see what it can do when announcements are made in September. The thing though is that without switching batteries, staying with the old battery and the heavier weight, the customers are extremely happy and would love to have as many vehicles as Mercedes and Tesla are willing to put together. So I'm kind of fascinated right now because there are all these data points that are flying around trucks. And basically, if you were able to get the new battery to go into the current light-duty trucks that are being produced and now leased by Mercedes to customers, I'm kind of shocked, because if Mercedes was seeing 60% cost reductions, if customers potentially are getting a 70% reduction in cost between electricity and repair cost versus a diesel truck, I think that's something of that ilk with the new battery would and should cause pandemonium, where you know, customers are frantically trying to get a hold of this product and implement it in their fleets. So I wanted to sort of run this by because I thought it was interesting. My previous report focused on 7-Eleven's response to their use of the electric vehicles in Japan. And I really was kind of skeptical of talking about Portugal because I just thought the numbers were mind-blowing, and real customers in use and numbers from them I thought were more significant. But regardless, there's enough value there for you know, fleet and all type of truck customers to make the change. I want to thank you very much for taking time out once again to embrace this logic of Tesla fan insight on what's going on with Tesla, and in this case, batteries and truck usage. Merci beaucoup. Tschüss, Max. Good. Au revoir. Tout à l'heure. Please like and subscribe. This is Greg of Tesla Fan Insight. Would love to hear your comments and areas that you'd like covered when it comes to trucks or other aspects of Tesla. Ode to Joy, Beethoven. Thank you and have a good day.